So Greg Fox is supposed to come with us on this Notre Dame trip.
Hi, Grandpa. Hey, Uncle Scott.
Hey, where's Greg at?
Oh, Greg couldn't make it.
Oh, no.
No, I had to get someone who could bring you a little more luck this time.
Oh! Look at that!
Oh! It's James!
Jamesy!
James is here.
And Chris gets out of the car and says, I got bad news for you. Greg can't come. And I thought, oh no, wasted ticket. What a mess. But he says, I have a leprechaun. And out jumps James Carlin. And he's dressed with a green hat, and he's got green glasses that are lighted up and flickering. And oh, how nice that was to see James. And he gets to go to his first Notre Dame game. We have three generations. So we got myself, we've got Chris, and we've got James. Three generations at the Notre Dame game. How special was that? Scott, my nephew, wanted to go down the tunnel and out on the field. And for $10, they allow you to do that. And so we go down the tunnel. We're running out onto the field. Well, they stop you right at the goal line, of course. And we look, and I remembered that saying of Rudy's, this is the most glorious sight I have ever seen. Notre Dame Stadium in the end zone, looking up at touchdown Jesus. It doesn't get much better than that.
There's Cousin Scott. What do you think?
It's cool.
Super cool.
I had many favorite parts of this trip, but some of my favorites were having a Portillo's sandwich on campus. So good. And then we went to this pep talk challenge, chalk talk thing, and it put James to sleep within like the first 3 minutes. It was a bunch of Notre Dame propaganda, my poor son. He knew better. Just fell right to sleep. But they had the shillelagh there, which was cool, and we got a picture with it afterwards. And then Cousin Scott was just sitting down on this bench, and all of a sudden the Notre Dame cheerleaders come out, and he's looking at it like, this is the best day of my life. So I thought that was cool. And then we looked inside the dome. I thought, wow, what could be in there? And it looks as good on the outside as it does on the inside. Then we went to the grotto at Notre Dame and lit a candle for my big brother John, who passed away from ALS. It was really spiritual and a very special place. To see all the candles, James lit the candle and placed it in, and it kind of felt like John was there with us that moment. So it was pretty special.
Being at Notre Dame with the golf carts that we got to drive around in. It was really fun to do, and we also got to look around the place. It was really fun. But my favorite part was being with Grandpa, because that was really cool and nice. Grandpa loves Notre Dame so much, and he even got me some ice cream. I really like that. And then we got to see Newt Rockne's grave, and Grandpa touched his face for good luck and stuff. So we'd have good luck in the future game.
So these guys are talking in the hotel we're at, and they're talking about the game, and I said to them, I said, you know, it's not that big of a deal. I said, it's not a matter of life or death. And they looked at me, and I said, oh, I forgot. I said, it's much more important than that.
James, what do you think?
So cool, look. Assembly.
What do you think, Dad? Pretty good?
Like a morning spring in the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are happy, all the world seems bright and gay. And when Irish eyes are smiling, sure they steal your heart.